Hi, this is Allison from EarthBabyYogaMama.com, and I'm happy to bring you this instructional video on how to make sauerkraut. The word sauerkraut means sour cabbage, and although that may not sound very appealing, it's actually quite delicious, and more importantly, it has many health benefits. Sauerkraut is a fermented food, and if you look throughout history, you will find that people have been fermenting foods since ancient times. And this is understandable because fermentation is a method of preserving food. Fermentation, when it relates to food, involves the favorable action of microorganisms, and in this case, it is the lactic acid bacteria, such as lactobacillus, that will be fermenting the cabbage and giving it that distinctive sour taste. In our culture, we hear so much about harmful bacteria and how dangerous it can be, but we don't hear enough about the other side. In fact, it is vital to our health and well-being to have a teeming, diverse culture of good bacteria in the gut in order to ward off bad bacteria, digest food, and assimilate nutrients. Ideally, we all would have been born naturally and exposed to bacteria from our mothers, then breastfed to properly colonize the gut with bacteria. But that is not always the case. And there are many other things that impact the good bacteria in the gut as well, such as the use of antibiotics. And these antibiotics are given largely to animals that are produced for human consumption. And they have also been found in the water supply. Drinking chlorinated water is another offender, as is the overconsumption of sugar. That is why it is so helpful to consume raw fermented foods in order to enhance the good bacteria in your gut. Not only that, but fermenting foods increases the amount of vitamins and minerals available in the food for your body to absorb. Ultimately, having a healthy gut means having a healthy brain. When your gut is healthy, an overall sense of well-being is achieved. Okay, so for this recipe, you will need 4 cups of shredded cabbage. I'm going to start by cutting the cabbage in half and removing the core. To save time, you might want to use a food processor, but I actually really like the sauerkraut to be really crunchy, so I'm going to keep it a little bit thicker. So I'm going to begin slicing it so that the pieces are about as thick as a quarter. And I'll begin putting that cabbage into a quart-sized mason jar. And you do want to pack it down. Going to alternate purple cabbage with some green cabbage. Get both of them in there. You do want to remove any air pockets. So pack it down tight. Sauerkraut is created in an anaerobic environment, meaning there is no oxygen present. So we want to be sure that the cabbage stays submerged under the liquid we'll be adding to it. Now, if you wanted to, you could mix the salt in with the cabbage and then pound away at it, and it will secrete its own juices. But I want to keep this easy for you. So, and again, I really like the cabbage crunchy, so I don't want to pound it out too much. Okay, so next, I'm going to take 1 cup of water. I'm going to add to the water 2 teaspoons of pink Himalayan salt. It's my favorite, but sea salt will work as well. You just don't want to use regular table salt. And I had some whey protein, some liquid whey, from straining some yogurt that I had just made. And if you want to see how you can do that, there's another video I have on how to make raw milk yogurt. So this is whey. I strained the curds from the whey, and I'm going to add this to the water. So that's 2 teaspoons of salt and 2 tablespoons of whey. If you don't have any liquid whey, you can just use an additional teaspoon of salt. I'm going to give that a little stir. And I'm going to pour that over the cabbage. I'm just going to push down again to remove any air pockets. And if a little extra water is needed, you just pour a little extra in. You want all the cabbage to be submerged under the water. Oops, there's a little salt that didn't make it into the jar, so I'm going to get all the salt in there. Okay, that looks good. Now, it's important that the cabbage stays submerged under the water. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a plastic bag and fill it with water. And this will help seal everything so that no air is getting into the cabbage. Put that in, and then I cover it tightly. Now while it's fermenting, you will see little air bubbles coming out, and it will kind of leak from the sides, so I'm just going to place it on a plate and I'll let it sit for a few days, and I will check back and see how it turned out. Okay, so it's been a few days, and our sauerkraut has been happily fermenting, and I have my daughter Zen with me, and we're going to try it out and see how it turned out. I made this one plain, and I actually experimented with putting some spices in this one. So let's try it out. Oh, yes. Very bubbly. And I wanted to say a note about these plastic bags that I purchased them at Whole Foods. They're PVC and BPA free. But if you're still concerned about using plastic, there are other methods you can try, and I'll get into that in a minute. But let's see how this turned out. The sauerkraut, Sam. You want to try some?
Sure.
I know you like cabbage. Here. Well, you're going to go through the drawer now?
Yeah, because you want to get something.
What do you want to get?
I just wanted to get,
Here, I thought you were going to try this. Oh, a rolling pin. Okay. That's fun. Did you want to try the cabbage?
Sure.
Okay, try a bite.
What is it?
It's cabbage. You like cabbage. Okay.
But
now in this one.
Fork.
Oh, you need a fork? Here, is that too big? Okay, how about if I just give you a little tiny piece? Mmm. Oh, yummy. Okay, so in this one, I just put in some mustard seeds, some cumin seeds, and some turmeric. I just sort of shook it in as I was going along. And that should taste really good. Mmm, that's delicious, isn't it? Do you like it? So, as I was saying, I put some carrots in this one as well. I thought you'd like to try carrots then. You want to try a carrot?
Sure.
It's sauerkraut. What's this for you?
It was that water.
No, that's the brine that it's been fermenting in.
I want some brine.
You don't want to try the carrot?
No, I want some brine. Mm,
that's really good. Brine. You want to try the liquid?
Yeah, because it's water.
It's cabbage water, I guess. Mmm, sauerkraut juice. Very good. It's actually not as spicy as I thought it would be for all of the spices I put in there.
Hey, this is small, but that's a small one.
Small for you? This one's a good size for you?
Yeah.
And this one's a good size for Mommy?
Yeah.
I see. Okay. Well, another thing I would have put in here if I had it on hand was ginger, but I was all out. So those are a few different things you can try. And I just wanted to show you, this is an airlock valve that I purchased from Amazon.com. Let me just show them, see? And this is the top to a gallon-sized jar. So if you really want to make a big batch, I ordered this jar. It comes with a washer fitted on the center there from therawdiet.com, and this was going back a few years, so.
And that.
Oh, you want to put it? Can you put it right in the hole? But you still will need to put something inside the jar to weight down the cabbage so that it all stays under the liquid. But you can experiment and see what works for you.
I want a little wet in there.
You want a little what in there?
That water in there.
You want the water in there? Okay, how about if I just pour a little in here?
Okay.
Oh. See, look, it's purple. And you can see that all the juices from the purple cabbage have turned the green cabbage purple, too. Wow. Wow. Oh, now you're ready to try some? Yeah, you need a spoon now.
It's more for me. Because it's full. It's not full.
It's not full. Yeah. No, well, let's just say bye-bye to everybody and say thanks for watching, and then you can try it. I'll get you a spoon, okay?
Okay.
All right. Well, I hope you enjoy your sauerkraut making experiences.
I want to make a video now.
We are making a video. See? See? You can see yourself on the camera there.
And you say, this is my daughter.
This is my daughter, Zen. And I'm your mommy. You're my daughter. And we made a lovely batch of sauerkraut. Well, again, it will keep in your fridge for many months, and I hope you enjoy your sauerkraut and all the wonderful health benefits that come with consuming raw fermented foods. Oh, boy. All right. Well, have a great day. Thanks for watching, and for more instructional videos, please check out earthbabyyogamama.com.